I have these two Asus VP228 monitors. They're, I guess, 21.5 inches wide. I think diagonally, I don't know if they're, I thought they were 21 diagonally, but I guess I'll measure it once I take it out. And I'm going to mount them here. I got this actually from a business that was moving. They were throwing it out. This brand new, this like standing, sitting desk thing is like $1,000. Obviously I wouldn't pay $1,000. I got it for free. Actually this chair too. But I'm gonna try mounting these monitors here side by side onto these VESA, is that what they're called? These monitor mounts. And I don't know if the monitor comes with screws that fit here, so I bought those as well, but if they come with it, I'll just return the screws. Okay, I've opened the box. I'm gonna pull everything out and see what's included. So included in the box, we have the monitor. It does have the mount points, but does not come with hardware, the screws to screw into there. It has a display port, HDMI, VGA, and a audio input, I think, because I think there are built-in speakers here. And then there's the power cable, this manual, which I think is just a normal manual, short instructions, and an audio, like a 3.5 millimeter male-to-male, I think. The base plate that would connect to this stand, and then an HDMI cable. So I'm going to, does this just fold? We'll have to see. I don't know if I take this off completely or if it does something, but I'm going to mount it up there. Maybe I should plug it in first, make sure it powers on and it's not broken. Okay, I got it plugged in. I'm just using HDMI. When I set up the desktop, it'll be a display port, so I had to get cables. I've never used that before. But the video card I'm using has one HDMI and three display ports, which I think you really only need one because you can daisy chain, but to do two monitors, I don't think I can use a single HDMI. So there, I'm just mirroring. Oh, it is low. Well, I'll just do max on this display, even though this one's only 1080. So I bought, these are TN panels, I'm pretty sure, rather than IPS or VA, which is, I know IPS is supposed to be better, but the one thing they're talking about is the viewing angle. So you can see here, if I go down, it actually doesn't look as bad on camera because it adjusts, but you can kind of see this black. I guess it's a reflection of the chair, but it does, see how the water, So there is a little bit, because it's just going to be me sitting at this computer, so the amount of angle is not going to be that big. To take off this little arm, I popped this panel plate off. There's those two tabs here that you just lift up with your nails, and then this kind of comes up like this. And I think I can just take off these two screws, and then this should all come out. And I'll just store that with the base plate in a closet. Okay, I got it off. I'm going to store the screws in here because this is threaded, so they'll stay. And I'll leave this thing on here so it looks finished. And then this also clips in, so that should not get lost. There, just like that. Next, I'm just pulling out these four little plugs to expose those. And I have a pack I bought of M4 10mm screws. I had looked at the manual for this thing online, and that's what it said to use it. So we can dry run it and just double check. And that feels correct. And then it said also it should take this, the wide one on here. It was like just under 4 inches, like 3.9 inches. Is that 100 millimeters, I think, or something? I don't remember. Yep. I'll stick these plugs with the extra screws. And then this thing actually slides off. It's actually a nice mechanism here. This plastic plate slots into there, and then watch this. It just goes click like that. So if I lift that. Okay, now I will screw it in here. Okay, I attached the one. I didn't put that much pressure because I'm just screwing into the plastic in the back. One thing I noticed, I have to probably straighten out the mount. It's a little bit tilted like this, but I can fix that. You can see here this plastic plate is not perfectly aligned with the black metal plate. See, this is it's probably off by like 3 degrees or something, but I can fix it. I'll take it off, and then from the other side I can loosen this, I think. That looks better. All I did was take this Allen key, and then I just loosened that like a quarter turn, and then aligned it and tightened it, and that's it. So now I'll put the screws back in and then hang it up again. Since I didn't show it on the last one, here's how you pop off this thing. You lift those tabs up. Don't have to pull that hard. I just don't have much fingernail. It's kind of hard to grab it. You can just use a tip of your finger, I guess. Huh? This one's hard to get. Barely, there we go. And then it's just these two black screws. Let's focus on the wrong thing. They're easy to take out. They've got some washers on them. I'll just set this to the side. Oops. I was looking at the camera. Just like that. And this slides up easily, just like this. Just like that. So now I will screw these back into here. And then I clip that one back in. Now I just dropped the screws in. I haven't tightened them or even aligned it. You can kind of just shake it a little bit to make sure they've fallen in. And then I will go backwards till it lines up. Now I go forward. You can twist faster if you're not aimed properly. If you grab this part and twist it, it'll spin faster and you're not putting much torque, so you won't over tighten it. And then I'll go diagonally to that one and then do the other two corners. Right now I'm basically just making sure the parts are touching. Okay, now all four are very loosely in. Now I will, with my other hand, just twist it just a little bit. Kind of just like closing a 2-liter bottle of soda, about that much pressure. Just like that. And that's in there, and that's fine. This is not going to be taking a dynamic load or anything. So now I will snap it in. Maybe I can do this. So here we go. There. Click. There, and these slide. It can slide, maybe from there. So I can push it to the center, and might have to do some wiggling to make them align nicely. Yeah, the right one I was able to just push with my hands and push it. It was some force. This one is really tight, I can't do it. They do have three these Allen screws. I don't have one that is gonna fit in there at this angle. So I might just spray a little lube on this and see if I can make it a little bit easier to turn. The lube didn't work, and I did find this screw underneath, but all it does is turn that, which makes this whole thing slide up and down, which makes this, like, I think it's just the tension on here, but it doesn't help. I think I can undo this screw and then pop off this plastic cap, and then I can pull this out and then loosen it. You can see the gap here is basically totally closed. Well, it's a little one. Up here it's really tight. Compared to here, a lot bigger. So I'll probably get it closer to match the other one. That worked, but I still need to take off this back plate to get direct access to these screws because they're obscured by it. So I have to loosen this, maybe just rotate it a little bit so I can access each of those screws. The last person stripped this thing really bad, so nothing. This is the correct size, but it's stripped. So I'll have to find one, hopefully something just a tiny bit bigger that I can jam in there and undo it. I was not able to get that thing loosened, so luckily it's basically just straight. You know, it's flat, it's not tilted or anything. So I just adjust the other one to match, which is like not perfect because it's totally flat all the way, so it's really wide. I would have preferred if I could tilt them both in a little bit, but I think it's fine how it is. I plugged one of the monitors into this kilowatt, so when it's off, it's 0.0, which is good. Some things have this draw. I turned it on now, and see, so it's startup, it goes up a little bit. Now it's searching for signals and there is none. So it's basically a black screen. I should have plugged in some source. With my laptop plugged into it, it's 10.1 watts. 10.2, yeah, 10.1 watts. The diagonal size is 21.5 inches. The first piece that I decided on was the graphics card, and I'll be using this PNY 4090. This is, I think, called the Virto model, which is based on the base specifications, so comparable to the Founders Edition. So there's not a lot of overclocking or special cooling or anything like that. And the next part was the CPU, and I'll be using the 13900K. Intel is switching to a different socket, I'm pretty sure, in the next generation. So this is kind of top of the line for this socket. I wanted to get an Intel instead of AMD for the QuickSync, which is good for encoding and decoding H.264 and H.265. For the motherboard, I'm using this NZXT N7 Z690. This is not generally recommended online, but I mainly chose it for the appearance. I just like the black and white. Some criticisms I heard was that NZXT partnered with ASRock for this motherboard, and I don't know the exact gripes about ASRock, why people don't like that, but other than that, on this board they say that it's a bit overpriced for what you get. Specifically, it's a DDR4 only, the RAM, and also the amount of I/O apparently is not what you get at other boards for about the same price. This I got for $290 on Amazon. And to me, I was looking at what input and output are included, and to me it seems fine for my needs. Oh, also with the 13th gen, I'll probably need to do a BIOS flashback and update this to accept this 13th generation Intel. But it has a BIOS flashback button, so that should be pretty simple. I'm cooling the CPU. I'm air cooling it with this Peerless Assassin 120SE White ARGB, which is relatively cheap for an air cooler. I think it was $40. Compared to something like 90 to 100 for Noctua with similar performance. It's 120 millimeter diameter fans. The SE just means that it doesn't have a cover over these crimps, which doesn't bother me. And it's white and has LEDs, which I was going for a black and white theme. The LEDs I don't really care about. One thing online people were saying that it doesn't come with the appropriate bracket for the 1700 sockets, but you can see on the box here that it does support it. And I opened this up and it does include the mounting bracket. So I had ordered that separately, but I'll end up returning because it is included. For the RAM, I chose DDR4 RAM, obviously with the motherboard, but the reason I decided on that was because I figured I'd like to just fill up all four RAM slots. And with the DDR5, there seem to be problems with people doing four channel, especially if you're running XMP, the Extreme Memory Profile. So you get good stability with DDR4, and to me, I don't think I've ever felt that bottleneck with RAM speed for the things I do. So this is a four pack of 4x16 DDR4. This timings are the CL16, then 18, 18, 38. I forget what those are. Those are some like number of clock cycles for reading different rows of something. I don't remember exactly. For storage, I just got this one, 2 terabyte NVMe drive from Kingston. It said PCIe 4x4 or 4x4. I don't know what the other x4 is. I just know it was a higher speed. Although when I got it, I realized it's only up to 3500 megabytes per second advertised. And I thought that was the spec for the 4.0 times 3. But either way, I think it's good enough. This was $109, I think, which is relatively inexpensive, at least compared to storage I've bought before. The power supply is a Corsair RM1000X, so it's 1,000 watts. The main considerations for the power are the CPU and GPU, which are pretty power hungry. Originally, I was thinking of doing something above 1,000 watts, but I think it will be okay from people doing benchmark tests and looking at their peak wattage usage. I don't think I should have too much issue. I was also looking at getting a platinum or titanium rated power supply, but I was looking at, well, it's like it doesn't seem like the components are directly tied to the rating, like the quality of components. And the efficiency for the amount of energy used is like, it's something like 98 versus 99%, which is, to me, it's somewhat negligible. Either way, this power supply seems to be good enough for my needs. For the case, I have a LandCool 216. I haven't opened it yet, but it's a white model with RGB again. This has pretty good reviews online for the airflow and build quality. Okay, I downloaded the newest BIOS on this flash drive. According to the manual and the motherboard, it says to format with FAT32, rename the file to creative.rom, and make sure that file is in the root. And that's the only thing on here. Next, I took the power supply and I just plugged in the, I think it's a 24-pin connection. I think you can see that, which says motherboard on the PSU, which is nice. So next I will, guess I'll plug this into the motherboard. And the PSU is off right now and it's not plugged in. I'm not sure the best order of operations, but actually, I'll show you what I'm going to press over here because it might be hard to bend when I. Oops, what's happening? So, there is the BIOS flashback button and this outlined USB. That's where I'll stick the flash drive, and then I'll hold down this button for 3 seconds until it starts to flash. And then eventually, when it stops flashing, that means it's complete. So, hopefully, this is not too difficult. Okay, so I'm going to plug this in. Make sure I do it the right way. looks like this. There, okay, it's in. Let me refer to the manual just to double check. Where did I put that? Oh, it's inside here. Just want to make sure I do it in the right order so I don't mess it up. So in the manual here it says, I think it was over here. Here it talks about BIOS flashback. See, they highlight that button and this, it's actually a different plug outline, but they're saying, okay, we did the download, I extracted it, I renamed it, have the correct format, the correct naming. Next, I plug in the power connector. Turn on the power supply. Don't power on the system, so I won't press the power button, which is over here. I just have to turn on the PSU. I will plug in the flash drive, then hold down the button for 3 seconds. The button will flash to indicate the process has started. Wait until the LED stops blinking and has turned off, indicating the BIOS flashback process has been completed. Okay, that's what I thought. So, like they said, I will plug in the PSU. And then I will switch it on. Okay, so it's switched on. Next, I'll plug in this USB, which I think goes this way. And now I'm going to hold down the button. I don't want to bend the cables too much, so I'll just do it from my angle. 2, 3. I don't see any flashing. So. Don't see any flashing. I'm gonna unplug this just in case and see if it's this way. I don't think that's correct. I believe it's this way. These plugs seem correct. Let's see the PSU. Oh wait. PSU is switched off. Weird, the switch was already on. Whoops. Okay, so now the USB is plugged in. Now I'm going to hold down the button for 3 seconds. 1, 2. I saw a flash. Okay. I saw a flash. It's a very dim light with this other light. It's flashing next to the button. Blinking green, I think. I'm colorblind, so I don't know. And see, I didn't even need the CPU or anything. And I didn't need to press the power button on the motherboard. They say that's the procedure. Still blinking. I'm not sure. I imagine it won't take too long. Another thing is, I have the components sitting on cardboard boxes for a little bit of insulation. I am on in a carpeted room, and this is a fabric mattress, which is not optimal. Another thing was like wearing socks if you're scuttling around the room. You don't want to build up static charge. Although it's pretty humid where I live, so I don't think I've gotten a static shock in this house since I've lived here, so I'm not too worried about that. Okay, it's still blinking. And they said, well, eventually it will stop blinking, and that means it's done. It's blinking faster now. Hopefully it's there's no errors with like a different color. I can't tell if it switches color. Still just blinking, kind of blink, 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 blink. I'm not sure how long it's supposed to take. Seems fine to me. This is what they said to expect. The light stopped blinking. Okay, I think that means it's complete now that the light has stopped blinking. Still off. So, they said once that's done, I can take out the USB. I think I'm just gonna wait a few extra seconds just in case it was doing some kind of a reboot and starts blinking again. So, I'm not 100% certain. So, just be safe. Rather be safe than sorry. Not in a big rush, so I'll just wait maybe another minute or so. Okay. I think that's pretty good. So now I'm just going to unplug the USB. Let me stop this video. Okay, I've put away the motherboard and PSU for now, so that is updated with the latest BIOS, so it should accept my 13th generation Intel CPU. So I'm gonna start putting the case together so I can just assemble all the parts into the case. And was on top of it. It's got a manual. This is just some styrofoam, I think, to fill out this box. There's this extra, you can stick this on the back of the case and stick an extra fan there. Here's a box with a bunch of hardware. Let's see. There's zip ties, screws, some rubber grommets, some bunch of fasteners. This thing covers up. I think you can stick it on the top panel. Yeah, maybe the top panel. And then if you place some fans, this will block the rest of the vent so that you're not getting flow just in a little circle like that. And then in here they have these little L brackets are meant to be a replacement for the anti-sag bracket. There's one of those included in the GPU, but that one is like a kickstand that fastens to, I think, the bottom of the case. It just sticks up so the card's sitting on there. And then this one fastens to the case so that provides another support. So I'm thinking I'll probably use this one rather than the one included with the GPU, but I'll see if maybe I have to use both. I'm not sure. Next, I'm going to take out the actual case and open it up. Okay, I took the case out of the box. Pretty big. There's two modes, they say, for water cooling or air cooling. And the difference is just that the motherboard is either placed down here for liquid cooling, because they're assuming you're putting a big radiator on top. For air cooling, you can shift it up. See, they have these arrows here. So the down is the liquid cooling. I'm doing air cooling, so I might as well just move it up. There are, I think, six of these standoffs. One, two, three, four, five, six, that I'll just shift up. Looks like not even an inch. About an inch. And then the other thing, I believe this cutout here, since the IO on the back of the motherboard or side is going to shift up that amount, I think I just flip this thing upside down, this little, that piece. So I will do that. There are actually nine standoffs. I missed the row on the bottom. I haven't moved them up yet, but there's this little piece in this case of screws and all that. See, it's got this hexagonal socket, and the backside is a Phillips. So this fits over so you can unscrew these more easily. So I'll use that to loosen them up. because they're too tight to do by hand. So as I'm flipping this piece around here, I notice that this standoff is in the way. After I moved it up into air cooling mode, see, I can't slide it out, kind of locked in, so I'll have to take that one out. And you need either a really long screwdriver to reach through this hole all the way to there. This one you don't, but everything is, well, the fans seem to be all plugged in, and they have all these cables in here, so I think probably I need to unravel these eventually, but for now you just kind of have to move them out of the way and reach back there to get those screws out, which I've taken out already. I've put the case to the side. The next thing I'm going to do is put the CPU, RAM, and storage drive in. I won't put the cooler in yet, but I think I do have to attach the bracket for the cooler on the back side of the motherboard before I stick it inside the case, so I'm going to do that next. I'll leave this running for now. So I guess I can do the CPU. I have to open up this box. Let me slide these. Some information here. Let's see. I think it's just kind of the same thing I saw on the motherboard. Mm-hmm. Standoffs. It's saying use whatever screws. Placing it in. Line up the arrow, which I will have to look at. And kind of just pop it in. I've seen videos of people doing it, so I think I'll be okay. Let's give it a shot. We kind of only get one shot if we mess it up badly. Whoops. Oh, there you go. Almost. So, let's open this and look inside. This way. Okay, so I see a bottom left, there's an corner arrow. So I know I just have to line that up. Let's take this out. Looks okay to me, what I can see. It's heavier than I thought. Never actually handled one before. Just make sure my hands aren't dusty. I don't want to get it underneath the socket. And I will pop this open to get it prepared. The case is open. Let that sit there. Let's open this. I see the arrow already on this corner, so lift that up. This comes up the opposite direction. Arrow here. I saw the arrow there, so I'm going to try to gently set this down. Okay. I think that's how it goes. It's not like perfectly locked in. There's probably a tenth of a millimeter, a little tiny bit of wiggle room. I'm just being delicate. Next, I'll push this down, I think. It feels wrong how much pressure I put on that, but I think that's correct. I probably shouldn't touch it with my hand. Yeah, I just saw a little like fleck on there, so okay. This little plastic thing, I'll just put this packaging away. Nice box. There's that little. Okay, next I'll put in the SSD. I think there are three under here. I believe the top two are normal M.2. I think the fourth one is like an M.2 or SATA something, so I'm pretty sure if I just do the top one, that will be okay. Yeah, this is always easy enough to switch later on if I did mess up, but I don't think so. Oh, it's magnet. There's magnets there. And I have some tiny Phillips. I don't know exactly which kind. It came into this bag of screwdrivers. Okay, where's my little Phillips? That's several. This one seems to be okay. This is a 000. Okay, let's. Magnet. Maybe a little bigger, one step bigger. Let's try this 00. That one's kind of stripping. Wow, what the heck? What in the world? This one is like in there. Okay. It might be because these are pointed tip versus flat. Let me see this one. Let me try one more time with this. No, that's not working. I'll try one bigger. Single zero. Yep, that worked. Okay, I think it's just actually a broader tip. So, single zero. Those are off. Let me just look underneath and make sure I'm opening up the right thing. Looks to be correct. And then I know that I take this off and there's a thermal pad there, so I'll have to take the sticker off before I screw it back in. So let's open up this drive. Cut it open. Cut it from the front to make sure I don't hit the device. I'll just cut it like this. Yeah, I shouldn't really be cutting on this surface, but okay, rip it open, just like that. Here we go, set this package on the side. Next, I just have to put it here. So the motherboard probably comes with these screws for this. Let me set it down. There, that slid in. And now before I do this, I do recall the motherboard having some little screws. That's why there are three of these tiny screws that go in there. Okay. Test it on here to see if the screwdriver fits. It looks like the same as the other one. So now I will, looks like I'm fully seated there. Push it down, yep, looks lined up. Can't get it, I'm gonna put it on my screwdriver first and hold it like this. There we go. To me that's bizarre that it springs up like that. I'm not certain that's correct. Not confident in that. That's kind of weird, isn't it? Let me see what happens when I do this. I see a cutout here. So actually, I put the screw on after. That's strange. Not how I thought it would go. Maybe I should look at the motherboard instruction again. Okay, it says take everything off, put in the drive. It does say to screw it in right away. There are three M.2 slots. Move the steel pieces. The topmost includes a heat spreader. They show it to. Wait, no, these two screws are the. Wait a minute, am I going? Oh, you actually use. Okay, that extra screw I have, I do not use it. I just use the included screws. Because those are the two holes for the magnets, and those are the two original screws that I took out. So, I find that odd, but okay. I think that's correct. I'll take off this sticker. And. Okay, suppose that's it. Yes, that this is the screw, the original screw. Wow, my hands are like fumbling. Yeah, okay. So there's no additional screw. I just used the one from this plate, which I didn't expect. I haven't seen that on other motherboards from videos I've watched. Okay. Okay, that is in. This is magnetic. Just sits on top. That is the only storage I have so far. Eventually, I may add other ones. Finally, we have. Let me stop the video and restart. And then the last thing I'll put in here before. Well, I have to do the bracket as well. I'll open up the RAM and we'll insert. All four of them. So this only goes in one way because this is an offset notch in here. So I don't have to worry about only filling the separate channels. Oh man. Here's one. Looks like it goes this way. First. Okay, let's unlock all four of these. This one is fixed. Oh. No, that's not a link. Whoops. There, that's in. Let's just do the second one. Wait a minute. Isn't that correctly? Looks angled to me. Guess that's correct. Oh no, this is bizarre. The PCB is kind of actually angled inside of this bracket. Weird. Anyway, slide it from the top, let it settle in, and then push. Click, click. Okay, and I have two more here.
Oh, that doesn't feel good. Okay, that went in. And this plastic, I'm afraid of snapping something. So there we go. Finally, the fourth one. Line up there. Oops. Okay. You push, click. Okay, here they look like they're in. Here it seems like it's in. So I have the CPU, the storage, and the RAM installed. The last one would be the bracket for the cooler. So let's stop the video. I'm gonna open this up and see what's going on. There are two fans, which I'll just place here. Instructions, which I will need. This warranty, I think, maybe. Throw it there. That is cool. Let's just pull it out and take a look. Looks pretty neat to me. Okay. So there's two main screws here. So those screws will go into the mount, which I'll have to fix to the motherboard. To the motherboard, yeah. So in here, here's some info. Intel 1700. Okay. It says, well, it's parts MNIEJABNG. So here. So there's an LGA 1700 and LGA 115X 1200. So I need the 1700 one. This one I'll put back in there. So that's part M, I guess. Suppose everything's labeled here. Okay, I need that. Right? M, yep. Yeah. And then I'll also need N, which is four of the little standoffs. I think everything is in here. Oh, there we go, 1700. And then the screws, I think, are also in here. Those screws, those standoffs. I think that's it. And then some thermal compound they give us in this black tube. And J, that's a thermal compound. I and E. I is the screw. E is the metal things in here. I have to see which ones. I think there's. Okay, I will need that. And let's see. Which one is it? E are the straight ones. So these curved ones I can put away. And I may just. Let's see. This I can put over here. I believe these are all the parts I need. So it says. This must go on the back of the motherboard. These stickers, I wonder what. I don't know exactly how this works, but I believe this goes on the back of the motherboard. Maybe I should just peel and look. Maybe it's an adhesive. It is. It seems like double-sided tape glue kind of thing, I suppose. Maybe I just stick it on, and then when I flip it over, they don't want it to fall down. Okay, well, let's move the motherboard into place. And there's also some clips, which I'll do later when I actually attach the heat sink and the fans. So now, the motherboard. So, this goes on the back. I guess just like that. Doesn't say anything about the sticker, but so, oh, that's the Chinese side. Here it says, install the back plate from the back of the motherboard, then place plastic standoff screws, or so, place the plastic standoffs from front side of motherboard. Install LGA 1700 metal brackets with screws. Okay, so from the back, I'm going to install this. I wonder if I should take off these pads. Let's take a look at the back of the motherboard and see what we're working with here. I may be out of frame. Let me move this stuff. Maybe this is better. Yeah, okay. Let's take a look at the back of the motherboard. Okay. It looks symmetric top and bottom to me, 180 degrees, so let's do a dry fit. Seems good. I see some dust there. I guess I'll take off the these stickers. Otherwise, why else are they there? They are a little off center, more on the top than the bottom. So let's see, is there any asymmetry? Not that I can tell. I guess I'll just follow the writing. The writing on the board is that way, and the writing on the card, I'll do the, or this fastener, I'll go the same direction. So here, my hands are kind of shaky. Okay, we're in. I'll just stick that lightly, the glue, and I'll set the board down, maybe on the bare cardboard so that there's a little pressure on that. Next, I need these screws and standoffs and the brackets. Cut this open. So I set this all day. Next, stick these four plastic standoff on here. I think they just sit there. Basically thick washers. They don't have any screws on them or any threads. And I see some print. I'll just put the print face down so keep it consistent. Okay, and then the screws and the brackets. Now, let me see. The brackets go. They go face up with these little screws sticking out. And I don't think these are actually square. Can they go either way? It almost seems as though they could go either way. On the picture, they show it going, they show it like this. Suppose I can do the same. Try to line it up before I drop the screws in. Just dropping them first. Then take the screwdriver. Actually, I'll start it by hand. Try to make sure they're not cross-threaded. Okay, and I'll continue going just very loosely for now. Just using the inertia of the screwdriver. Very loosely. Okay, it doesn't seem like there's a lot of, it's kind of settled into place. Now I'll just tension it with two fingers. Okay. And that looks good to me. I think I'll put this into the case before I continue. Is this straight? This actually looks crooked to me. Oh, there is a little bit of a choice here. You know, let me double check. The instructions did have something. It did say something with the holes. Mounting hole. They point to the... I guess there are three hole punches kind of all in a line. Can barely tell, but it seems to point to the middle one. So I suppose I may have done that a little haphazardly. Let me unscrew this again and then just double check if I can see the... Oh yeah. Let me undo it. Make sure I did this carefully. That seems to be in the middle. It's kind of floating to the side. Bizarre. One, I suppose that's middle there. Okay, it actually does look more aligned now. So I guess when you put it in, be sure to stick it right in the middle. This one looks correct to me. All right, now let's move on. Next, I'm going to put the motherboard into the case. You can see in here, the case comes with all kinds of screws, and it says screws for motherboard, and they are these ones at the flange and the round head. So you can see maybe yep, the one I'm holding here, as opposed to this one, which has the hexagonal profile. That's for the PSU. So let's place the motherboard and then start screwing it in. Actually, let me just double check screwdriver size. I guess I'll use my big screwdriver for this. Okay, just gonna be careful setting this down. Find the standoffs. Not quite there. Doesn't quite feel right, it's not lined up yet. Getting close. Okay, I think it started to settle into place. I'm just going to slightly wiggle stuff. Wiggle up and down. Okay, now it feels like they're in the groove. One thing I'm going to check is this IO seems to have mated properly, so I think I'm ready to start screwing it in. Okay, I'll try to get that hard to reach one first. This is a magnetic screwdriver, but it's pretty weak, the magnetism. Okay, and I'm not going to tighten it yet, I'm just going to get it till I start feeling some resistance. Okay, just a tiny bit. And I'll kind of go around jump around so that it's even. Everything can slide into place. Okay. Okay, the four corners are started. I know there was one in the middle. Wait a minute. So okay, well, I'll just keep doing the ones I see for now. May have to take off some of these protective covers. This will be all three on the right side. Then I see the another one on the top. And then there should be one here and here. So let's lift this up again. I know it's at least partially covered. This is the M.2 or M2. Let's see. That's a little bit. It may be underneath that. Well, I might as well just lift it up and take a look. Let's find that screwdriver that works well. Set these to the side. Be careful not to lose it. Okay. Doesn't seem like it, unless, is that it? I believe it was lined up, so it would be right under here. The bottom one. Maybe I'll check the manual. I don't see any, so I'm going to put this back on and then take a look at the manual. I don't see anything in the manual about it, so, and honestly it seems like there's enough screws to keep this from moving, 7 out of 9, so it would be these two here that are not screwed in from the motherboard to the case, so those standoffs are just to keep pressure, I suppose. So I don't think I'm supposed to pull this off as well. No, let's not do it. I'll double check, maybe I missed it in the manual. Oh, shoot, that magnet. Dang. Okay. so I'll just put this together. Okay, that's in. The next thing to do, I think, is connect the cables from the case into the motherboard. And this part I'm a little bit lost. I'll have to check the manual, I think, and see what exactly is in here. There is a hub for the RGB, which the case fans are connected to. So I know there must be an output that I have to plug into the motherboard. There's kind of a mess of cables, so. Okay. Yeah, I'll have to check the manual for the case and see everything that's included to know what to plug in. Something I'm gonna try is, can I even see this? Oh, up top, let me just carry this up. You can move this panel from the top to the side, and I think I'm going to do that because I'll just have it up on my desk here. So I have to pop this front off, which I thought just pulls, but I might have to, let me look, to pull from the bottom. Let me just see. I have to look at the, I can get that off again. I don't want to break it. Let's see how to take the, how to take off the front panel. Says you just pull off from the bottom, so there, okay. It's a little bit scary. It's just held on by these clips like that, so okay. And then we do have all these fans in the way, and I'll have to move I have to move the wires as well. I have to move this. I think I may have to take off these fans. I wonder if this will come out all together. Let's do it. Okay. So I think I want to take off. Okay, I think just these top and bottom two will do. Let's loosen it a bit. It's gonna come up. Let's do the bottom actually, so that it doesn't bend. And two. Three, four. I think this will take both fans out, like the whole frame. Oh, wait, there's one here and one here. Oh, yeah, okay. So there's six. Place this in the middle, just keep track of my screws. They're all the same, but sometimes the threads are a little different, and I imagine it's easier to just put the same screw in the same threaded hole. Now, take out these fans. Let's see where these cables go. Let's undo this. I'm making some slack in the cables. Hopefully, yeah. I just want to set it on top. It's a little bit tight. Barely made it. Okay, well, next I will take off this plug, this dummy panel. And then I'm going to move the top one down there. And I'm going to have to move these plugs. I mean, these cables, so kind of undoing it and thinking, how does this work? Not like that. I'm going to just take them all the way out. This one, first take this up. Very visible, but actually, let me set this down so I don't drop it. Maybe I can familiarize myself with some of the cables coming out of here, see where they go on the motherboard. Okay, this I want to go down there, and these cables I think I'll go here instead. So I'm going to get these out of the way. There. Set this down again. Just trying to be careful. Okay. Now let's fasten it there. Get my screwdriver again. Hopefully there's not too much tension on this. It's right here. Yep. I didn't get it threaded. It's okay. Okay, there. I think the weight of the cables are okay to just let them hang. Shoot, there goes one screw. I see it. Okay. Okay, I think that's correct. And then I'll screw the top one in. So I'm assuming it was the middle. It's funny, there are three. Or is it this top thing? It must be the middle, it just doesn't seem. What are those screws? Maybe it was that. It's not flush with the top. Oh, it is. Okay, it's these two little screws, two little holes on top. I think those other ones are for fans or another AIO or something. Okay. That's not too bad. Now it's just a matter of getting the wires put in a nice position. These will have to go. So there's it's two USBs, USB-C, audio, power, and a reset, I think. This will have to go through here. And so now I'll just thread it through. To be careful I don't snap anything there. For now, I'll just let that hang. Let's see. These fans will have to go back. I'm a little thinking about how those fans fit. These wires went along here. And how was this fit in there? I think they were in. They're in. Wait a minute. It's like this. That was it. See, I'm a little skeptical of the. Okay, how are those wires going to go behind the fan? This must slide over it like this. Oops. Must slide in here. That. Maybe not. It's gonna get kinked. I suppose those are getting there. This does not feel right. Get these. There's no, previously they went over. Yeah, so maybe I'll do that. Okay, before I do that, is this really going to fit on the left side? This is a bit bizarre. It seems very tight, and this is going to have to go down only a little bit more. I'm just not convinced that this is a complete fit. Maybe I'll push down. Seems to be getting there. There's gonna be some pressure on these cables though, which doesn't look very good. I don't like what I'm doing here. Okay. Slide one of these over at the time. This one's tight. Is that this one? Okay, that's slack. Okay, they're over. Okay, that's lined up all right. Some resistance here. I guess everything's in. Oh, here, this one panel is on the back side. It should be front. That may be the cause of interference. Okay, now that feels a bit better. I had accidentally threaded the, I don't know if that's visible on the camera, maybe not, one of these tabs I had stuck on the inside instead of the outside. Okay, now I can put the screws back in. It's thumb screws, I believe that's next. Yeah. Maybe. Yeah, I think it's okay. There are places to like strap down the cables here, and maybe I should do that now. I don't think the fans get in the way. I mean, they kind of do, but I'd rather just fix the fan. I'll put the fan in. Okay, Maybe it's difficult to see. Here are the cables. See, I have that fastened. I'm going to try to stick these cables and wrap them using these little holes in the bottom. I'll stick a zip tie and just fasten these down. Okay, so I got the front back on. And so on here there are four connectors. This one's labeled audio. This is F panel. This one, I don't know what it's labeled, but it's a... It has one pin missing. I have to count how many there are. And then this one I think was USB-C. So I'll stick these through here, I think. And hopefully I can plug them in to the motherboard. I see the audio in the far left corner. That one says front audio. And it seems to have the same pin missing. Second, it's like the fourth one. So there's that one. This one seems to go here. I'll have to check the motherboard and just double check what they are. This USB-C looks like maybe it goes here. And then F panel is missing one in the corner. And that has 10 things. I'm not actually sure. What is it for? There's audio. It might be the other USB. I'm not actually sure. It could be a reset. I don't know. But I'll have to check the motherboard. So far, I only plugged in a few things, just three. From the hub and back here, there are three cables I plugged in. There's this PWM, it says fan in. There's this power, and this ARGB. If you follow these down, actually, I only did two for right now. The power one is here. This one, I think, will go into the power supply. But let me check. I think it's a SATA. Anyway, the other two come around. So one is for the lights and one is for the fans. The one, what does this one say? I matched the color. This one said, what does it say? ARGB1. And so that was that one, the ARGB1. This one was SysFan1. It has spots I see for SysFan 1, 2, 3, and then up here they have 4 and 5. But since this hub here already, the case has some controllers for all the different fans and lights. So hopefully these will work with one another. I don't know if just plugging in the one there will work, but we'll see. I'm going to flip around this panel because I plugged in this header, which is, I think, USB 3 from the front. But the cable has to take a really tight bend here. It puts a lot of pressure here. So I think if I move these holes to be further to the right, it'll be nicer. Okay, so all I did was undo these three screws and then flip it like that or this way. Yep. So now it should be less tension or less moment bending on the cable. Now, so far, this was the most confusing part because not exactly sure what everything is. So these cables I already showed where I plugged them. The ones from the front, there was front panel, front audio, then there's two USB things, one USB-C and USB 3. So the USB-C was this one. The USB, oh no, that's the C, I think. That's USB 3. It has two cables, one for each of these. And then there's front panel, which is the power button. You can see it's right next to the power and reset buttons, which makes sense because there's a power, and I suppose this is the, oh here, there's the power, and I'm guessing that's reset. Yeah, so the other ones there, there were audio, which came from the front as well. I showed that before. Audio on the far left. Next one was the ARGB1. And the other one was fan. So that all the fan, I'm sorry, the lights from the hub were there, and then the fans from the hub is there. So all three of these fans, two in the front, one in the back, all plug into here, which are actually already pre-plugged in. And then output from this hub where the ARGB one and the fan one, whatever. So next, I think, is power supply. Okay, into the PSU, I've plugged in, this is the 24-pin power connector, let's see, the main power for the motherboard. See on this end? It's split into two pieces. These also go onto the motherboard. They are, they call them EPS. I know these cables are labeled CPU. See on the power supply, there's PCIe or CPU. These cables, they label as CPU because they break into 4 and 4. And then I added 3 more PCIe for the graphics card because that will need 3 PCIe. Optionally, there's 4. If you look here, it actually splits. It takes 4 in and combines them into 1. And they say you can do either 3 or 4. Although the fourth one that I have here is labeled CPU, so it breaks into 4 and 4. I would use all 4. But the other thing is, it's fully connected inside. You see there's 4 leads in there. But if you look at the other PCIe, I'm not sure if it's, I forget if it's the motherboard or the output. I think on this side here, if you see, one of them is empty. Let's see if I can open it up. Kind of hard with one hand to get it. There. If you look inside, you see that? One is empty. So, I think I'm not going to use the fourth one, at least not that cable, because I don't know if somehow it's different. Okay, I'm going to try to slide the power supply in. There was also a SATA cable I have in the power supply, which is for the hub, the light and fan hub. This one here needs a SATA. Okay, now I got to slide it in there. Dang, my desk is too messy. Not a lot of room. I'm gonna move. Okay, I just rotated it a bit, moved some things out of the way. Now I'm going to slide it in. Okay. Hopefully these aren't too much in the way. Ooh. Yep. These cables are pretty kinda in the way. Let's see. Slide it in. A lot of tail on this thing too. And I just want to be careful I don't break anything. It's okay so far. I actually could have used that side thing. There's some that the cables come out of the side instead of there, but maybe this is okay. Okay. Just making sure I'm not really breaking anything. This big 24 pin is like kind of crazy. From this angle, huh? Okay, that's all right. Now I have 4 screws from the case. It says to use these ones. They're similar to the motherboard ones, but these ones are hexagonal. Not sure if there's much of a difference. They might be threaded differently, so. Yep, there's just 4 screws here. I plug in. Screw in. And the fan is on the bottom side because there's a vent there for intake. Okay, those are in. Now it's just a matter of threading everything through and trying to keep it relatively flat, but not kink everything. So, probably start with the main power cable. Flip this around. Well, actually, there's this SATA back here, which I can just plug in. Maybe I'll do that later, though. Okay. Let's see what it looks like. Can't see anything. Okay, try to get this giant power cable in and those top ones. Okay, let's see. Big cable will come from here. Okay. First, I'll just go with this. Make sure it clicks. Started, it barely clicked. I'll just push on it. That's in. Okay. Funnily, it's almost taut in the back, so at least there's not a lot of slack. Let's see how. Next, I'm gonna do those top two. So there's an 8-pin and a 4-pin. Pull the 8-pin out of there. Go like this. First, let me get it before I start putting that in. Oops, got caught on a screw. Let's go directly here. And this should be upside down. Turned. It's a funny angle. Okay, it clicked. That's nice. Okay, cool. I'm sliding the cables under the clips back here. Seems to work. And then there's one more. Four pin. Which I think they are. You know, I don't know if there's any difference. should probably Google it just in case if there's like a left and right side. One is square and one is all four. So it takes the one with the square. Okay, good to know. It's funny, the power cables barely make it. The one with the square, this one, and goes like that, right? Yep. Okay. This one, I can feed back through there extra. Maybe. Hopefully it doesn't put too much tension on it. Okay, like that. This. Put it here. I'm gonna do one clip. Seems like enough tension there. There's also the SATA cable. So, looks okay from the front. Let me pause it for a second. Okay, I flipped it around. This SATA needs power. This comes from the hub. I don't know which one it is. I think it's that one. Yeah, see, this is a little bit dangerous, I feel like. Anyway, SATA from the bottom. Here. These are daisy chains, so like these all share power, so later if I add drives, I can do that. Maybe I'll allow these to be like that, and use the very end one here. Let's see, like this, and then... Looks like that. Oh. So it goes like this. I think there might have been something on the motherboard on this side. SATA? What's USB? I'm trying to find it. There's some extra ports on the motherboard. I want to see what they're for. I think there are four SATA power connectors on the motherboard, and I think that is to power these USB on the back, so I do think I need that. This has four connected, so I'll try just sticking this in the power supply now. Kind of late, but okay. That's right, it's way back there, so this is kind of a pain now. Let's see. I hope that's the right one. I believe it is. There we go. Time to feel around. Yeah, this was a mistake. I'll probably just take the power supply out to do it because it's going to be kind of a pain. Okay, I unscrewed the power supply, so now I'm going to just rotate it so I can get this in here. Okay, that should be enough. Wait a minute. Oh, that's sideways. Okay. Kind of using my fingers like chopsticks. Oh, shoot. Let's just rotate more. Why am I doing this? Okay. There we go. Part of me is thinking, should I just plug the rest of them in? Because there seems to be enough room in the back to just jam it, but no, I think it's easier to unscrew it and rotate like this. Now, get this 24-pin crimped again. I don't like how much you have to bend it, but I suppose it's because I have this hard drive bay, which I will probably utilize eventually. Okay, now I can screw it back in. the heater. And so far it's been okay. I think the trickiest part is like all the wiring. I didn't wire this hub, that came as it is, but I suppose each fan, I guess there's fan power and there's lights for each of them. And they, you just kind of do 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Yeah, I guess. Oh, I see, this is kind of unplugged here. Put on that. Oop. Ooh, that bends. Okay. Okay. Oop. Alright, anyway, let's finish putting this power supply back on. And now I want to feed the SATA through. Not that one. Feed this one through, I think over there. I'll rotate the case again and take a look. Alright. So there's these four here, I believe. Wait a minute. This doesn't even look like the right shape. Let me see. No, that's a different kind of SATA. I should have tested before I plugged it all in. Anyway, yeah, this looks very different. This is much wider. Okay, well. Okay, let me check the motherboard again. Those SATA connectors are for data, I'm pretty sure, and not power. So, yeah, I do not need that SATA cable. So I'm going to unplug that, so I'll take the power supply out and unplug it again. But I probably won't film it, because why? Okay, I got that one unplugged. It's pretty simple. Okay, this, I'm going to try to bundle up a little bit of this slack from the SATA cable. Oops, SATA. I will probably just stick it here on the right side, seems fine. And it's a little bit thick, these connectors. I'm not certain that that's okay. Maybe I should put the slack here. Is that better? Or maybe up here. Like this, and then maybe like that. Maybe this is okay. This is a little bothersome. I don't like that exactly, but. Okay, these three are going to go to the GPU. It's kind of crazy that all of that goes to one component. This, I might just go this. And then, let's flip this around. GPU is gonna sit here. I'm gonna come look at the height. The GPU came with this SAG bracket, which I guess is the same mechanism as the one that came with the case. And this one's black from the GPU. I think you screw it in. And what is it called? Some standoffs. I'm actually not sure where it goes. Does this panel come off? doesn't really feel like it. I'm not certain actually this goes. Let me look at the instructions. They show these going in the screws. Huh. You know, these are actually the screws that were missing when I did it here. I think they're underneath this part. I gotta check the motherboard if that actually comes out. Okay, I'm going to install the cooler. And so I have this thermal paste. I wonder if I should wipe that down with alcohol like people normally. I see them. I think because it's clean and I haven't done anything before, I should do it without it. I have the cooler here. Let's make sure I have the right fasteners. I think it's just included. That's a pink bag. Okay. Then there's a sticker. There's up and down, so it's going to go this way. And there is a left or right kind of. There's the labeling. Should I just look at the picture? Does it matter? Look at the instructions again. They have the logo toward the RAM, so that's the way I will do it as well. This way. Okay, so I'll put the thermal paste down, take this off, and then there we go. Let's get my screwdriver ready and check that it fits. Oh, wow. Makes it, okay. I've actually never applied thermal paste before. Okay. I know you can just do a dot, but you can also do an X. I'm going to do a little... Looks clean as I rub it. Okay. What the heck? Okay, I think that's an okay amount. Should be enough to get coverage, and I don't think I did it too excessive. We'll see. Now, take the sticker off. I think you could rub both down with alcohol, but now, what's that middle thing? Push. There, now it's catching. Now it's starting to catch. Good. I'm just going back and forth. Hopefully that's makes it even. And I'm guessing I go till the springs are compressed, or are they tensioned? I don't know. Does it say anything? Apply, install heat sink with a screwdriver, install fans. There's kind of a dial in the middle, but I don't think I use that. Still turning. Hopefully I don't break anything. That'd be very sad if I broke the CPU before I ever used it. It's feeling kind of tight there, so I'll probably just... I think I'm gonna stop now. Maybe this one. Okay. Trying to look. Do I see any spillage? Don't see any, but we don't really know. So now it's just time to hope. I will need the clips and these, maybe those cables. And okay, I've got these clips and cables, four clips, two cables. There are also some fans. Let's see how the fans assemble. B and G. Clips. B is the fan, G is the clip. What's the other thing I saw? These wires? They might just be extenders. Y. Fan, Y cable. Oh, to connect them. Oh, this is a Y connector. So that they're in sync. Okay. Okay. Let's see. Let's undo this cable tie. Take both of them out. There's so many things. One's for the fan and one's for the RGB. Yes, one is 3 and one is 4. This 3 is not sure. Anyway, should I put them this way or that way? Probably the logo on the outside would make sense. So the yeah, and this will go. This fans, I'm trying to think which. Does this go to a header in the back? Or should it go on the motherboard? Yeah, I don't know, because I actually have three different, I have different brands for everything, so. Clip, let's see how this clip works. I think this should go like this, basically. Should I cover the RAM? Should I go on the back side of both? Is that okay? Which way does it turn? You know what? There's rubber here, so they must go this way. I suppose I could go this way, but I don't wanna fight this. I'm going to, for now, let's see this. I'm going to do it this way on both sides. That seems to match the shape of these fans. I think it's pushing through this way, so hopefully this is okay. And let's see if this works. How do I fix it? I don't understand how they fit. Fastens. Like that. So these put onto that. doesn't feel right. It's like a lot of pressure. It's like distorting the shape of the fins, which feels wrong. Maybe I go here. That seems too. That doesn't seem right either. Well, let me pause this. Oh, it started right away. Okay. So, it does put a lot of tension on the fins, but once it's set, it's just there. So, all you do is clip. Hook these on, whoops, like this. See, I have the cables toward the top because I think that's where I need to get them plugged in eventually. I didn't double check that, but anyway, they hook like this from the front of the fan, like that, and then slide it in, line it up, whoa, then, these just, you pull it back, clip it in like that. And then I just make sure it's centered left to right. This one is elevated because my RAM sticks up a bit, but no big deal. Next, I need to check, I suppose, there was a Y connector where I could connect some of these. And I think it's so I could connect these three, this one, I gotta look up how this works. Okay, so this is for the power, for the fan speed. It is right here, it says on the motherboard, CPU fan. Next to it is AIO pump, which I don't have, and I don't think that's equivalent. So. This Y connector I will put into there, but first let me connect both of these ends to the fan speed. Let's see. I think these daisy chain ones are for the RGB on the fans. That seems right. Kind of bizarre though, one of these has three and one has four. And I suppose, I don't know, I guess something with to do with them sharing power, I guess. Anyway, I will connect both of them into this Y. There's one, the other one is here. That doesn't feel simple. There. Okay, and then this goes into the CPU fan, like that. A little bit tight. Okay, it went in. I'll probably be able to tuck this slack through the back. And then these, I think a daisy chain, maybe one of these or something. Yeah. Let me see the manual again. They do show. Oh, okay. Yeah, okay. So one of these goes in to the RGB header and the other one just daisy chains off of it. So I can just plug one into the other to start like this. And then I should be able to just plug this in and the header. I don't think there's another RGB controller on the motherboard. I think I just do it on the case hub, probably. Because I have that ARGB. Let's see, LED 1, LED 2 on the... Let's see. Okay, I just daisy chained the Peerless Assassin CPU cooler lights right here to the case fan lights, which I don't know if that's going to work or if I should just directly plug it into one of these LED headers, like separate controller. I don't know. It seems like here, I don't know. I hope it'll work. We'll see. I guess I'll test it. Hopefully I don't blow it out, but we'll see. I still haven't tested yet, but I decided instead of daisy chaining to the other fans, I'll just directly go into this JLED 3. So the case fans are all plugged into 4, and I think they're all daisy chained together. So I'm just going to take the third spot. I think not worth risking it. Okay, I fed the 3 PCIe cables through the bottom. Oh my gosh. A lot of stuff now. And now I'm going to use this squid cable they gave me, this merger, to plug in the 3 PCIe cables. This will provide power to the GPU. And I'll just have to line these up again. And I'm only going to use 3 of the 4 because, as I've talked about before, I'm not confident that the cable is compatible, that CPU version of this 8-pin connector. Probably is, but I could always add it later if I figure out that it's fine. Okay, let's see. Does it matter which side? Not really. I guess I'll take this side. And I think, it's this one. But really, any of these power cables, if I don't plug them in all the way, that's when you have risk of fire. I'm pretty sure people are having that problem before. Okay. I've been pretty careful with plugging everything in all the way, though. This is a little finicky because they are kind of break away. Oh, what the heck? That one's tough. Actually, I might be able to, let's see. There, okay. It must have been misaligned or something. And this is the last one I'll use. And I think the 4th power cable is only a... I think it only matters if you're going to overclock the GPU. I'm not sure. But these 3 should be okay. And I'll take the slack later. Next, I'm going to install the GPU, but I'm going to lay this flat. And I have to take out the top 3 slots here, so maybe I'll do that first. Okay. I get the feeling I may need to move this whole plate because, I don't know, this is so tight. I just don't know if it aligns properly. But I think I can just undo these screws on the side and move it. Well, we'll see. I definitely need 3 of these off. So I'll start with that. Pretty sure I just need to do this. Dang, it's very tight. Crazy tight. And it's all like stripping almost. There we go. Okay. Let's try to get these up now, okay? All right, those came out pretty easily. Now, the GPU. This is half the cost of the whole computer. Ridiculous. Now, I'm going to kind of dry fit. Check it out just to look. It looks right. Seems about right. Seems about right. So, I'm going to start peeling off the protective plastic. So that. I felt static. I felt a static shock when I peeled off that plastic. That's ridiculous. Well, we'll see. Hopefully it's okay. That's actually crazy. Oh well. Anyway, let's... Okay, let's leave that. Let's not push it. That's stupid. Okay, hopefully I didn't just destroy that. That would be very sad. Oh, make sure this is the correct way. Okay, it's down, and then it's going to pop up. I think I got all the stickers off. Except for the three on the fans. Okay. Lining it up. No. Didn't work. This cable is almost in the way. Okay. 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 That's there we go. It's in. Now, time to screw the side back in. Dang, that static shock from the sticker makes me very scared. Well, one way to find out. Oh, shit. Okay. We'll see. Ay, ay, ay. That's right. Difficult to get these screws in. I don't think I'll need the sag bracket. It seems to be pretty well fastened. But let's see. Once I stand it up straight, we'll know. Yeah, the brackets they gave, I don't have the appropriate mounts on my motherboard. This motherboard's not very user-friendly, honestly. And now to get to the M.2 there and to add one there, I have to take out my graphics card and probably the CPU cooler to get the top one. But anyway, I don't think I'll be doing that. Finally, I just need to plug in this power cable, and I'm going to check that I'm doing it the right way. So that looks correct to me. Oh, what the heck? Very tight. Okay, I think that's it. Finally, I'm going to stand it up straight and pull the slack through to the back of the case again. Let's see. Feels pretty sturdy, actually. So now let's get the slack extra cables in the back. Rotate this a bit more. It's actually heavy now. Started in the right direction. And figure out which one I need to pull. Let's see. There's other cables in there, little wires. Just check both sides, I guess. This one I'll hide like that, just bend it. Wow. This is gonna have a cover here. Just gonna smush this a bit. Let's try to bend each of these little cables individually. It's a bit messy. Oh well. 1, 2, 3. Let's try to line them up. 2. This one. This one and this one. Gotta switch places. That. Just organizing cables, I guess. I'll stop this video. Okay, I put the back cover on, and then the motherboard also has these Wi-Fi antennas, so I'm gonna put them in. I think it's Wi-Fi, what is it? It's 6E, I think, which I don't think my router even supports that, but probably run Ethernet eventually, but for now this will work. I suppose I use both. I don't know if I actually need both antennas, but they're there, so why not? So, like that, for now. And then the last thing is I need to plug in the display port for the monitors, and then the power. Okay, I got it all closed up and plugged in. I don't yet have a USB drive that's big enough to install Windows from, so I can turn it on and check. Okay, I got it plugged in and closed up. I haven't powered it on yet, but I don't have a USB drive that's large enough to install Windows. I do have some, but they're not big enough, so I can probably boot it up and check that the BIOS works and that I see everything, so maybe we can do that. Oh, maybe I should plug in the keyboard and mouse. Let me do that. Okay, pardon the messy desk. Let's click the power button and see what happens. Oh, wait. One more thing. The PSU. There. Now the power supply is on. Imagine it just bursts into flame. Okay, let's see. So far, the only thing I noticed, I think, maybe that isn't LED. Okay. I see a red light on the motherboard. I don't know if that means anything. It's possible the, I need to plug a, one of my displays into the, oh, no, there, that one's reading. It's not going to be able to boot in. There's no operating system yet, but ooh, look at that. Nice. This, I know, can go up to 32 if it gets rated. No, it's processor, sorry, the RAM. Anyway, it boots up. I'll have to, XMP profile. There, that's correct. I don't want to click this yet, but eventually, I'm probably just going to turn it off for now. This is not correct. Air cooling. Air cooling. But actually, that's what I wanted too, is just white fans. I think it looks nice. Let's see it in the dark. That would be kind of cool. Darker lights, at least. Pretty cool. All right, well, wonder if I can see the GPU from here. I mean, I am plugged into the GPU to get this, even though this is motherboard information. Let's just click advanced mode. Somewhere I'll have to see where the GPU would be found. I have to go to a meeting now, so I'll have to do this later. I think, exit? Discard and exit? Or save and exit? Auto duration power limit. No, let's just discard and exit for now. Shut down.